funny.
Vegas Aces playing against the Phoenix Mercury. From the 2K booth with Brian Banifatemi and Tim Swartz, I'm Blake Suniga. Thanks for coming along. It'll be the Mercury off the tip. And here is Diggin Smith. A little. Uses the glass to finish the layup.
Was not fazed at all by the bigger defender on her, and in the low block, I thought she might be a little fazed.
Yeah, you wouldn't think that would be her comfort zone, but hey, she looked pretty comfortable right there, didn't she?
They get it again.
I don't know if she was playing to the crowd, trying to make the highlight reel. I don't know. But no need for the fadeaway there.
Here's Diggin Smith, shoots over Wilson. Diggin Smith's shot is off.
She's a very strong finisher, guys. I'm surprised that she wasn't able to power that through the defense.
The D was ready for her that time, and they had to be. She is strong in the paint.
For three, Kia Nurse. That shot off the mark. And Las Vegas the other way now, down low. Wilson with the bucket.
What vision from Gray, one of the top points in the league. She does not miss open teammates.
Rossi outside, back to Diggin Smith. Back to Rossi, five on the clock. Here in the first quarter with about 2 minutes gone by. Gray with it. Pass to Cambage. That one's in. Her first basket of the game. She is one for two.
Well, you might be surprised by Williams' court vision, but she isn't. She knows she can make sharp passes offensively.
Now here's Nurse. Excellent D there from Liz Cambage. Williams can't get it to go. Phoenix trailing here. Now Nurse. Doesn't get it to drop for her. Good D by De'Erica Hamby.
Physicality and drawing fouls are just two of Griner's many strengths. So a little contact won't really bother her.
The first free throw is good.
A recurring WNBA All-Star, Griner's really made her mark in this league.
She hits both from the stripe. Here's Williams. And here in the first, about 3 minutes in. 17-foot shot on the way. Three, no good.
A real defensive lapse there. She's not a player you can leave open for a jump shot. They're lucky she didn't punish him there.
Now here's Diggins Smith. Six to shoot. Let's it go from 14. Asia Wilson grabs the board. Pass to Gray. Back to Wilson. Shoots over Diggins Smith. A nice shot by Wilson.
Look how quick she was to bite on that pump fake. Left her feet way too soon.
Outside, Diggins Smith. Pass to Taurasi. From deep three-point range.
You can tell she thought that triple was gonna fall.
She's just shaking her head after that miss.
Right side, Williams. To the paint. Here's Cambage. And she makes that one.
Well, you just love to see concentration like that for players, and Cambage doesn't let anything stop her from getting buckets.
Now here's Diggins Smith. Wyatt so far offensively searching for her first points of the game. With some arc, and she lays it in.
The touch from Diggins Smith. As a point in the WNBA, you need the teardrop. Helps beat shot blockers.
Cambage with it. She's guarded by Griner. A nice shot by Cambage. And it's the Mercury with the ball. A four-point game. And they're looking for a way to score here.
Yeah, they've had a tough time taking the lid off. They got to score.
To the left wing. Now here's Diggins Smith. Defense is right there.
Effectively scans the defense. Diggins Smith puts her high basketball IQ to good use.
And the Aces call time here.
Looks like the coach saw some things out there that need adjusting, and it's going to take a little time to talk it over.
Yeah, never a bad idea to use a timeout if there's something that's got you concerned.
We'll go for a different look here. Pass to Young. Back to Plum. And here is Carson. Five to shoot. Here's Wilson. The rebound by Hartley.
The fadeaway about her only option once she decided to shoot. Defender had very good position.
And that one goes in as she's fouled. It'll be 3 points if she can convert the free throw. And that puts them up. It's a one-point game now.
And coming into the WNBA, Megan Walker was already a standout talent, a top 10 pick who was conference player of the year during her junior and final season.
Now here's Plum. Young, and it's good. Assisting on the play was Kelsey Plum.
Intelligent passing to make that basket possible.
Pass to Taurasi. She uses the glass on the layup.
Effective around the rim. Taurasi is well-rounded. She can finish with a multitude of moves.
Now here's Young. Inside. Harris can't hit. And the Mercury with possession. And it's Bria Hartley penetrating. Bucket is good.
They're finding lanes to the hoop every time down. Five buckets in a row from the paint.
And on the flip side, the defenders have to show more fight on the interior.
Or at least some fight.
Now here's Plum. He hasn't yet put up any points in this one. Lays it up and banks it in.
Well, when you get in the pick and roll, Plum can shoot out of it, drive, pass. How do you defend that?
Rossi outside. Off target from three-point range.
Her shooting numbers slipping this quarter.
Outside Young. Basket counts.
Excellent use of the 15 or so footer for a point like Young. Hitting these opens up the floor.
And the Mercury call time here. Left side. Pass to Walker. Just five on the clock. Back to Hartley. And stolen by Carson. Here's Wright. Finished off the break.
Well, that fast break, it went according to plan.
Yeah, nice job recognizing the opportunity was there to push it, and then just perfect execution.
Such a joy to watch.
Now here's Taurasi. Serene Kakakunwe. Shot from the wing. That one, no good.
She has been anything but her usual self this quarter. It's been ugly.
Now Carson. Outside Plum. Mercury with the rebound. Hartley from down in the low post, it goes.
Well, Hartley lacks in length and physicality inside. She more than makes up with the agility, a tremendous skill, and she finds a way through to get her shot.
Pass to right. Here's Carson. Here's Plum, and the shot is good.
The second she got around the pick and shook her man, it was straight to the bucket for the easy deuce. Very well done.
Now here's Taurasi. Shoots over Young. That one misses. Would have counted had it gone. One quarter in the and it's been a close one. Aces ahead, up by three. And the second quarter about to get started. We'll be back in a moment. Guys, what's your take on the Aces so far?
Well, we've seen them really get out and establish an offensive rhythm.
And they're finding ways to score, you know, playing well and getting good offense.
The Aces with the lead. Outside Plum. Clock at four. The three ball doesn't go that time. Now Phoenix takes it the other way. outside, digging Smith. Goes back up, and she sinks the layup.
Coaches love to see hustle, a.k.a. what Diggin Smith is all about. And I love how she's just always infusing a winning attitude for her team.
Now here's Plum. To the right side. Here's Young. Score it. Her third straight basket in three attempts.
You sit back and enjoy the poise from Young. Maybe not the highest percentage shot with the contact, but she still sinks it.
Pass to Walker. Turner. Now here's Walker. That misses. Had a chance to tie it there. Plum with it. That's in, coming off an assist from Jackie Young.
Yeah, Young is such an effective ball handler. Spots the wide open shooter and passes the rock.
Pass to Walker. Diggin Smith, guarded by Young. And it's Skylar Diggin Smith penetrating. And she was fouled on the way up. Two free throws for her. Jackie Young picks one up.
Well, probably the right play defensively. If you can't get the block, send him to the line.
Exactly. You want to prevent the layup, give him a little knock, and then maybe they'll think twice about coming down the lane the next time around.
It does send a message.
And the first one falls for her.
In 2019, Skylar Diggin Smith missed the entire season due to the birth of a child. But it's great to see her back on the floor for this league, for the game of basketball, one of the most popular players in the WNBA.
And so she hits both. And the Aces with possession. 3-point lead. Pass to Cambage. Yeah, count it.
Well, if you're going to foul Cambage, you really need to foul her. She's so strong, fantastic at finishing through contact.
And she's got her first opportunity at the line here tonight.
It was 5 years between WNBA seasons for Liz Cambage. And what'd she do when she returned to the league? Lead the league in baskets made. A talented offensive force.
Now here's Nurse. She hasn't scored yet. That, I'm sure, will change. Outside, Diggin Smith. It's hauled in by Chelsea Gray. Here's Williams. The putback. Great positioning on the putback.
Wow. I mean, come on, that's 10 straight points in the paint. The defense, it's just nowhere to be found.
They have to start committing more bodies down low.
Now here's Diggin Smith. She's got 8. Here's Little. Can't get it to fall, and she's missed her second after making her first. Camby outside. Gray outside. To Hamby. Williams drains it from 9 feet away.
The ball movement on this run has been fantastic, and it's a big part of why they've been able to get good looks.
Absolutely. The defense unable to react quickly enough to deal with their passing.
Here's Kia Nurse from the arc, and again Phoenix no good. And here are the Aces now. Their defense has allowed only 4 points in the quarter.
Zero problems running rim to rim for Hamby. A gifted athlete, her long strides make up lots of ground quick.
Timeout called the Mercury. It's been quite a game for Cambage.
He's absolutely worn them out in the paint. They need to come up with a plan to limit the damage she's doing inside.
outside for Diggins Smith. Hartley. Pass to Diggins Smith. Hartley with it. Clock at six. And it's out of bounds. The Mercury able to retain possession here. Williams with the steal. Pass to Gray. Now here's Cambage. She's guarded by Hartley. Back to Gray. Williams. And the Aces, another three.
And as they continue to dominate, you wonder just how much higher this lead might get.
And it really could get out of hand because their defense has been just as excellent as their offense.
Great overall game.
Now here's Little. Pass to Nurse. Over Hamby. And a shot by Nurse, no good.
Boy, I mean, they can do nothing right. They cannot take the lid off.
They need a bucket in the worst way possible. They have got to stop this run somehow, or it's really going to get out of hand.
Now here's Gray. 16-point lead, the largest margin of the game.
They depend on her to convert those chances. A lot of times, even with solid defense draped on her.
And they're going to count the bucket and send her to the line. 3-point play. So it'll be Brittany Griner shooting. And it goes on Raquana Williams. The Mercury making a switch here.
Getting to the line and hitting your free throws, it's a good way to get back into a game. It stops the clock, extends the game, and they're doing that. They've been perfect from the line so far here in the second quarter.
Cambage's shot is off.
Well, I mean, to me at least, Brian, it looked like it was going to be an easy 2 points there.
You're right, Tim, and she's got some angry words for herself after that miss.
I mean, the only explanation is someone must have gotten their signals crossed if she winds up that wide open in 3-point range. And I'm sure that was not the plan.
Back to Gray. Cambage. Outside Williams. Shoots over Taurasi. Williams can't get it to go. Outside Diggins Smith. Pass to Nurse. Little left side. And a miss there with a chance to cut the lead to single digits. To the inside. Cambage. That one is good again. She is 6-for-8 from the floor with that basket.
Her efficient scoring. A nice lift to their offense tonight.
Nurse outside. Pass to Griner. Shoots over Cambage. No good on the shot. A bit long that time. To the middle. And Williams gets it to go.
He's coming to life after a slow start in the first quarter.
Here's Nurse. She's covered by Hamby. Diana Taurasi on the wing. Takes the three. Nailed from three-point land.
We're watching a pure shooter go to work. Taurasi simply has great mechanics on her jump shot.
And the Aces call time here.
Coach saw the players were getting winded and called time to give them a quick breather.
them that stood out is their ball movement.
Things are definitely clicking, and more importantly, it's tough to defend.
Outside Young. That's her fourth basket of this game, and she's only taken four shots. Off to a good start.
That's the third bucket in a row from the paint. And I know nobody likes a traffic jam, but this defense needs to clog those lanes in the middle.
Yeah, nobody likes a traffic jam. We can agree on that. They can't allow the offense to get those high-quality looks inside.
Rejected by Courtney Paris. Now here's Carson, guarded by Walker. Young's shot is off. And here is Diggins Smith. 8 points for her. Outside Diggins Smith. Pass to Taurasi. And there's the whistle. Fouled hard on the shot, and we'll go to the line. That's on Essence Carson.
A steady and consistent scoring threat. Taurasi isn't really afraid to use her body down low.
And this is her first free throw of the game. And she knocks down the first one.
Now in the later stages of her Hall of Fame career, maybe the best career in WNBA history. Diana Taurasi understands her role to be a mentor both on and off the court to her teammates.
And good on both. Here's Plum. She's got six. Outside Young, and she gets it to go.
If someone is open, Plum will find them. She's got phenomenal court vision.
Pass to Turner, to Rossi. Outside Diggins Smith. And here's Turner, down to five on the shot clock. To Rossi. Ring Kakakunwe, good.
He got caught standing around that time and giving up the second chance points.
They need more effort than that on the boards. That can't happen.
Absolutely.
Outside Plum. The tray. Here's Paris. And so we've reached the end of the first half of play. Aces ahead. They're up by 11. And we'll step away briefly, but get you right back out there for the start of the third quarter after the break. A tremendous game from Liz Cambage.
Well, in terms of her points in the first half, that's pretty much what we've come to expect.
Which tells you really all you need to know about what a strong talent she is. I mean, I'm going to bet that she adds a lot more to her totals after the break.
Welcome back to the start of the second half. Big margin on our hands, but we'll see if that gap narrows down in the final two quarters. Gray with it, looking for her first basket still in this one. Here's Wilson. Mercury with the rebound. Now Taurasi.
The D did a good job of clogging the middle once she got inside.
Outside, Williams. Pass to Gambage. It's stolen by Griner. Here's Nurse. Little. She's guarded by Wilson. Now Griner. Shoots over Gambage. Griner misses. Rukwana Williams goes in, and it's blocked by Diana Taurasi.
Not how you want to kick off the second half with three straight misses.
Here's Nurse. Off the mark, had a chance there to trim it to single digits. From the stripe, a nice shot by Wilson.
They get one to drop, one of four here in the third.
And they could use a big shot here to get this offense going.
Yeah, too many empty possessions. I mean, it's simple, they need points.
Here's Taurasi on the money from 12 feet away.
You just love to see that poise, and Taurasi always seems to have the game under control. She's a true vet.
Now here's Gray. She's been patient so far, nothing yet on the scoreboard. Gambage inside. She is guarded by Griner. And it's going to be two free throws. Drew contact on the shot. It's going to go on Brittany Griner. And this will be her second and third shots at the line here. First free throw is good. Good at the line. And the Mercury with possession. Trailing by 13. Taurasi with it. Williams there.
They're just killing them in the paint.
You can say that again. I mean, the defenders aren't being nearly aggressive enough down low.
They're just killing them in the paint.
Thank you.
Timeout called the Aces.
Well, they want to tinker with the game plan a little bit, and now's the time to do it.
Yeah, there was clearly some things going on out there that the coaching staff just wasn't a fan of.
Touch over 2.5 minutes of basketball played here in the third quarter. Here's Gambage. Count that as her 7th field goal in 10 tries. She's shooting a nifty 70%. Taurasi outside. Back to Hartley. The 3-pointer off the mark. Pulls it from 20. Here's Hamby. And that one is good with the extra effort on the glass.
Never a player short on effort. De'Erica Hamby, a winning player. Second chance points can be the difference most nights.
Now here's Nurse. Still getting warmed up offensively. No buckets yet in the game for her.
They can't afford to give her that kind of look.
Well, it came off a good screen, but still, as a defender, you have to fight over the top of it.
And you need some help as well.
Here's Gray. Outside, Williams. Pass to Gambage. Over Griner. And it's blocked by Brittany Griner.
Makes great use of her length and instincts. Griner is easily one of the best shot blockers in the WNBA.
Taurasi can't get it to go. And they're running. Here's Hamby. And the officials whistle a foul on the shot. The bucket's good, and she'll go to the line.
It seems like every year, De'Erica Hamby just gets better. And that's a testament to her drive and work ethic.
Pass to Walker. And here is Hartley. Plum with the rebound.
A slight rebound advantage for them. One more column in their favor. It's all adding up.
Well, you look across the team stats, it's one of many areas they're winning, and they've secured a big lead.
It looks very sharp tonight.
I'm loving it.
And up the court comes the Mercury on the break. The Mercury with another miss.
Well, she's really losing her confidence out there. Correct me if I'm wrong, that's zero field goals made in the game.
Now here is Hamby. She's got eight. Here's Hamby. And she drops in the layup off glass.
Boy, not a lot of resistance inside, and they're taking advantage.
That aspect of this game, the play in the paint, has gone almost entirely their way.
Absolutely.
Got a hand on it.
Big denial by Hamby. She's always in the top 10 in blocks because of her height and her smarts.
A difficult situation for Phoenix. Here's Turner. And it's good. Assisting on the play was Kia Nurse.
Very clever passing. She put that ball on a silver platter for her.
Here's Young. She's got 10. Cambage. She's guarded by Griner. Plum can't hit.
She's tried to get it going, but the shots simply haven't been dropping for her.
First outside. Shot clock at 6. The rebound by Asia Wilson.
With her missing literally everything she's put up today, you can see why the score is what it is.
Now here's Plum. 6 points for her. Pass to Wilson. Solid play on the low block, and that one's good. And it's the Mercury with the ball. 17-point game. Timeout called the Mercury.
They'd seen enough scoring in the paint and wanted to send a message to their team. Lock things up inside.
Yeah, you're right, Tim. I guarantee you this talk centers around cutting down on all those points coming against them in the paint.
And maybe it's more help, it's the front of player. They've got to try something.
Is making a change here. Hartley, right side. Outside, Diggin Smith. Here's Wilson. That's good. Basket number 5 on a 5-for-8 shooting night.
She's having quite the quarter here, shooting the ball really well and just an impressive performance on all cylinders.
Pass for Nkakakunwe. And the shot count. She's fouled. That's a chance for a 3-point play.
You can't leave anyone open on Diggin Smith's team. You're asking to get hurt when you do that. Story of perseverance. Neo Rankoff Okunwe went to college in Canada at a Division II school, but has worked her way to the Canadian national team and the WNBA.
Yep, that one goes.
She's shaking off that slow start and giving them a boost here in the second half.
Outside, digging Smith. Murner. And again, Phoenix, no good.
A solid performance inside. You know, they're rebounding. It's been terrific.
They're putting together a great game, aren't they? Strong performances throughout, and they've just been strong on the glass.
And it sets a tone.
Six on the shot clock. Essence Carson from outside. It's good from long range.
I'm not sure that was the play they had set up, but it was too good a look to pass up.
Pass to Hartley. Floats one up. It's rebounded by Young. And the Aces with possession. A 21-point lead, the biggest in this game.
The foul drawn by Young, it's hard to keep her in front of you, and that opens up so much more of her game.
And she's got her first free throws of the night right here. And the first one drops.
The top overall pick of the draft by Las Vegas in 2019, Jackie Young came out of college early, becoming the third junior to ever be taken with the top pick after Candace Parker and Jewel Lloyd.
Both shots good from the stripe. And it's the Mercury with the ball. Now here's Diggin Smith. She's got eight. Little outside. Pass to Griner. And Asia Wilson with the block.
Incredible timing by Wilson. Of course, she's 6'4". That helps. But her defensive IQ also helps her deny opponents, too.
Now here's Taurasi.
She did so well to lead her teammate right to the ideal spot. That's the kind of playmaking coaches like to see.
Here's Williams. She has seven. Takes the three, and she's good on the three ball.
So skilled at the catch and shoot game. Williams doesn't need much time or space to get her shot off.
Taurasi outside. Tried to come right back with a three of her own, but it's no good. At the end of the third quarter, a huge lead, and this one may already have been decided. The Aces on top, just dominating this one. We're going to step aside for just a second, but join us right back here for the start of quarter number four next. And let's take this opportunity to show you our State Farm assist of the game.
The winner today coming from an unlikely source. It's the sweetest dime of the day. What a plus it is to have a post player who can pass like this.
Yeah, it's a huge boost to an offense. It adds a whole other set of options to our team.
And we're rolling here again with the fourth quarter. Might not come down to the wire, but you never know. Now here's Griner. Pass to Taurasi. Outside, digging Smith. Shot clock at six. Releases. Offensive rebound, Mercury. And it's Turner missing. Gray right side. Now here's Young. 2 points. That one goes in.
Her position might be guard and primarily point guard, but Young can score inside. She's 6 feet, tough, and quite crafty.
Now a timeout called by Phoenix.
She's certainly been looking for a shot so far, but it just hasn't been falling. Frankly, I think she should look to pass more and get other folks involved.
go for a different look here. And it's the Mercury with the ball. Pass to Smith. Now Petty. Here's Cunningham. The fadeaway.
That one rolling around and rims out. You got to give them credit for the job they've done on the boards.
Well, guys, they've done a lot of things well, but their rebounding is right at the top of the list.
Inside, Harris. Great pass to set up the lay-in.
You know, you look at the stats, the assist totals, they just jump out at you. They're way ahead in that category. Ball movement has been key.
It's just a different mindset these teams have had. It's been good, safe basketball from her up to this point. And she went a decent amount of time before her first turnover.
First minute and a half of basketball played here in the fourth quarter. And it's Cunningham with the rebound. Pass to Petty. Clock at six. Here's Ring Kakakunwe. Here's Cunningham. And again, Phoenix no good. And now the Aces on the break. Good work there as it goes.
They've had assists now on their last three baskets.
Everybody always thinks it's passing that gets you assists, but also their movement off the ball, it's created those opportunities.
Here's Petty. Pass to Cunningham. To the paint. Smith. And again, Phoenix no good.
Physically, there's no doubt they've been the stronger team, and that 10-rebound advantage tells you all you need to know.
Not to mention what it says on the scoreboard. They're really pushing them around.
Here's Wright. She can't get that one, and it's Phoenix the other way. And they've been looking out of sync offensively.
They need a bucket in a big way here to regain some confidence.
A versatile big with an array of moves at her disposal. Defenders struggle to keep up with Smith.
Alana Smith taking two shots.
Two shots. Relax on the first.
And she can't get the first one.
The prototypical big for today's game. Smith can beat you inside and outside.
Good on the second free throw. Here's Las Vegas. They've only given up 1 point in the fourth quarter. Here's Paris. Shot clock at five. Shot's good by Wright.
Another good pass. Impressive offensive execution from them.
Yeah, passing has kept the defense off balance. Four straight field goals made off an assist.
Pass to Rain Kakakunwe. Lots of room. Rebound by the Aces.
And not only is their lead big, but their advantage on the boards is huge, too.
They've been the aggressors, plain and simple, outworking them inside.
And now we see them really working it inside.
Yeah, getting quality looks around the rim. That's fueling this run.
Here's Smith. And again, Phoenix no good. Pass to Wright. Harris. Right outside from deep. That shot, no good. And the Mercury going the other way now. Down low. It's rebounded by Wright. Pass to Park. Count it.
Nice pass there to set up the bucket.
And 10 of their last 12 points have come off assists.
Now Cunningham. And two free throws coming up as she misses that one, drawing the whistle on a lot of contact there. It's going to go on Tanisha Wright.
Sophie Cunningham at the line for two.
The first one falls.
An incredibly successful shooter in the college game. I can't wait to see everything Cunningham can do here in the pro game.
And that's good as she hits both shots. Right outside. She can't hit that time. And the Mercury going the other way now.
Not her best game, but they're getting it done collectively.
Pass to Smith. Here's Ringkakakunwe. Petty. And here's Smith. Carson covering. Just four to shoot. It's hauled in by Park. Back to Carson. Right. Here's Park. Off on the layup. Smith. She's guarded by Wright. Ball's knocked loose. Essence Carson with some nice deep. It's Tanisha Wright on the wing. Outside Carson. She can't get that one to fall. And it's Phoenix the other way. Pass to Cunningham. Doesn't go for her. Some solid defense from Tanisha Wright. Outside Carson. Hart. They need this. Back to Carson. Mercury with the rebound. They need a good offensive possession.
Yeah, it's been a long time without a bucket. Focus after defending the shot. She didn't quit on that play. Followed it straight to the glass for the rebound.
Right outside. Carson. And the call is going to be, yep, an illegal screen.
The idea of setting a screen on that play, it was the good idea, the right idea, but the execution was not.
Yeah, you really want to set a hard screen, but you also want to make sure it's a legal one.
Here's Cunningham. To the inside. It's rebounded by Wright. Pass to Paris. To the paint. Hart. And it's good with time running down on the shot clock.
Great job spotting her teammate near the bucket and firing the pass in there.
And here is Petty. And here's Smith.
At the line are your Phoenix Mercury. Alana Smith taking two shots.
And the first one at the line is good. That's also good, so she hits them both. Right outside. Pass to Paris. Now Petty, out to the right wing. Pass to Cunningham. Just five to shoot. High arcing shot, and she takes it up and lays it in.
Plays with lots of movement offensively, great from the perimeter, but also capable of doing damage inside.
Now here's Wright. Here's Park. Puts one up from 19. It's tipped. And she recovers it. The shot will not fall. Here's Petty. So it's the Aces winning this one easily.